Jesus. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father God, we come before you. Lord God, we acknowledge your awesome presence, and we acknowledge, Father God, hallelujah, that you are a stronger partner in this relationship. We thank you, Father God, hallelujah, that you are a strong tower. We can run into you, Father God, and find refuge, find strength in you. Thank you, Father God, for your great love and mercy towards us. Thank you for your grace. Thank you, Father God, for the salvation, Lord God, hallelujah, that you paid for the ultimate price on the cross at Calvary. Father God, hallelujah, we commit ourselves to you again this evening. We pray that you come and touch our hearts and open and enlighten our eyes of understanding. Speak into our lives, Father God. Touch our hearts, Lord God. Make a change on the inside of us, Lord God. We pray, Father God, hallelujah, that you will shine your light by the power of your Holy Spirit, Lord God, into the recesses of your heart. Let your word take root very deeply in our hearts, Father God. Hallelujah, and grow and bear godly fruit, bear Holy Ghost fruit, bear your kingdom's fruit in every area of our lives and through our lives. We thank you, Father God, for what you have done, for what you are doing, and for what you are going to do in our hearts, Father God. Thank you, Father God, for the opportunity to come to your house and join together, Father God, with our fellow brothers and sisters and worship you tonight. Father God, bless this our gathering tonight, and we pray that you will deliver and deposit to each person our portion that you have prepared for this particular service. Thank you, Father God, by the power of your Holy Spirit. We cover this meeting with the precious blood of Jesus and cover the ministry of your word with the shed blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father God, we be careful to give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise. And in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen and amen and amen. And turn to the person next to you, shake his or her hand, and give them a smile. Praise the Lord. And say, "Ani somi nandrendre." Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Eh? Hallelujah. You are most welcome this evening. Hallelujah. Wherever part of this area that you come from, or whether you came from Suva, hallelujah, Monikoso, hallelujah, Balolo Street, hallelujah, Volavola Street, and hallelujah, whatever the name of your street that you came from, praise the Lord, hallelujah. It's our prayer that God will touch your heart and do something big on the inside of all of us, amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Ini sakit dapat kita tahu di mana kami di sini ada dai. Nui tak kita ko ni na bawa itu orang dua kali guna keluar dan orang dua imbur. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Kita guna mui boleh tahu. If you got your Bible with you, can you come to our foundational scripture in Psalm 119? Psalm 119. Praise the Lord. It is good that you come to this kind of teachings, that you bring a pen, hallelujah, paper or notebook or something so that you can write on it. Amen. Quando ti comai dando un pen, quando ti comai dando un nome, i vola, quando ti comai marawanyo, mai baka bulaki na ve tiki ni vola tabu na ve kai na ve wa sei takati ko bade sona ka, doing doing a bully, brother na ka, doing doing a bully, do you talaga ke na lumo. Doing doing a song on, doing doing a kene lumo. Sin to toba ta ke doing a song on. Different services, different fellowship, different anointing. Amen. Because God is going to say something much more impacting, hallelujah, than what's in the note. Eh? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Just because you got the note, that doesn't mean you got everything. Amen. So God may say something in particular in that particular service that you need to write down. Amen. Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. Are you in Psalm 119? Come to verse 9, 10, and 11. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, how can a young man cleanse his way? How can a young woman, praise the Lord, cleanse her way? By taking heed according to your word, with my whole heart I have sought you. Oh, let me not wander from your commandments. Your word have I hidden in my heart, that I might not sin against you. Praise the Lord. Eh? Nomo ni bosa sa tunga ne romango meu kaku kina ni dalo. Ni dala e matamu ni. Praise the Lord, eh? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Eh? The defense system The defense system or the defense weapon for overcoming sin is the word of God in our hearts, eh? Praise the Lord. And I sat some by level. And it tamata lo tena ngoni ni kwa waya me pa tawani ti kono nona mbula na bosa ni kalu. Ona sini ra ni bolu kono ibal bala na nona mukoko nga pa tamata. Praise the Lord. You need to fight sin through spiritual weapon. And that takes the word of God and the spirit of God, eh? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I believe you've got your notes for this evening's session. We didn't complete last night, eh? So I hope you brought your last night's note. Yeah? Aw sa na ba no niti kanyo kota ti ko ba na no mo note. Ko solya na lambo ni mata linda sin ni pagaw ti ay. Praise the Lord. I believe we're up to number 11, is that right? We haven't done 11 yet. Is that true?
Yes.
Yeah. Don't know, eh? Praise the Lord. Number 11, eh? On dating. Now we're going to break it down, eh? They say in the music industry, break it down, break it down. So now we're going to break it down. Eh? Hallelujah. We're going to break down dating. What exactly is dating? What is the purpose of dating? What you are supposed to be doing while you're dating? Praise the Lord. We're going to break it up, eh? Tona lo duro mai ngor tona. Ser-ser ka dai urutan ni dating me tu reda mata. What exactly is dating? Praise the Lord, eh? Sa sa toro ti ko. Sa 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 ti ngor do notes. You got the notes there. Praise the Lord. Okay, number one, what is dating? 2, 3.
Marriage is the ultimate goal. Never date someone
you don't consider. So you see that? Praise the Lord, eh? Amen. If you're not thinking about marrying that person, then don't date them, eh? You're only wasting your time. Praise the Lord. Eh? Plus, you begin to form that soul tie. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yeah, you begin to form that. Yeah, you establish a soul tie, and then, of course, then we've touched that transference of spirit. So can you imagine if, I think I've done this before, you have, you know, four exes. You date one girl, let's just say it's a boy. Date one girl, leave it. Date one girl, leave it. Then date one girl, leave it. Then date one girl, leave it. Then you come now to the fifth one. Eh? And all these people that you've dated, you've connected, you've established soul ties with them. Praise the Lord. Then you come to the fifth one, the one that you're currently dating. Amen. Eh? And now, you've got the transference of spirits from those other girls. And they come on you, and then you what? You transfer it to the fifth one. Amen. Eh? Unless you cut it off, eh? But all... At the same token, you are wasting your time because you've dated four, never the intention of marrying them. Praise the Lord. Yeah. So in other words, there's a big deliverance ministry gonna be done to you, eh? Especially if you're gonna marry this fifth one, eh? Because you're gonna cut off the soul ties from there, and you're gonna chase all the demons out from all those four people. Amen. Eh? Dua tala mata nama kasabi temor lem tala mata nama kabi. Ni tu sapu tu kiku kere tu na temor kor tu bayu tu na baya. Amen. Nobody say anything now.
Amen.
Yeah. Dua bayu mencu mai say something, eh? Praise the Lord. At least I know that you're alive. We just sang that alive, alive, alive. Praise the Lord. So I'm hoping you are still alive. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Yeah. Dona baka sa mea ko ngame biyo nono ko mo tarong ama de. Ubi kem dosa date chiku mai. Did this exactly happen to you? But no, please don't, eh? Don't answer that question. yeah, because some people are gonna, eh? They're gonna empty their closet today over here if I tell them to testify about it, eh? Praise the Lord. And after that, then we do the deliverance ministry on them, eh? So, no, that's all right. Praise the Lord. I leave that to Pastor Atish. Hallelujah. Amen. Number two, 2, 3.
Be careful not to compromise on the standards or guidelines you've set for yourself. It is easy to make adjustments to your guidelines than to mend
your broken heart. Well, Robin, young girls, this is where you come in, eh? Young girls, because you are, excuse me, you are emotionally wired. You are emotionally wired. You have a very sensitive heart. Eh? You say the wrong thing. We say the wrong thing to you. You get very, you know, you get very emotional very quickly. Praise the Lord. Do ba kayo binabay? Ayoyong. Eh? So some kind of response. If you dating somebody and then you get dumped and that boy goes with another girl, you get broken on the inside. Eh? Ngayon doon na nakalewo, mesengay may mga binakatake na elo. It's a big job, big ministry to try to mend a broken heart.
Amen.
It'll take a great, you know, a length of time and ministry and encouragement to try and mend a broken heart. You know, there's a song by the Bee Gees, eh? How do you mend a broken heart? It just came to me then. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Eh? How do you mend a broken heart? Well, I can tell you how to mend a broken heart. Eh? Get in right alignment in your relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Because only Jesus Christ can mend the broken heart. Nobody else. Eh?
Amen.
You can sing the song of the Bee Gees and, you know, whatever you want to sing, but it's not going to mend the broken heart. Amen. And so some people, when they have the broken heart, they want to find the first boy that can... they can get, thinking that if I have another boyfriend as quickly as I can, this will resolve the broken heart. Sometimes you add more to the problem, eh? Sometimes you just pouring kerosene on the fire, and you just become more broken. Eh? So be careful. This one he says set a guideline, eh? Like dating standard. You can, if you're thinking about dating. So I'm just saying it. Yeah? You can say like this: I don't kiss on the first date. Man, someone knew what they're saying. Yeah? You can say something like that, eh? I don't kiss on the first date. Yeah? Brother, give away. Brother, if you want to kiss, go kiss that tree over there. But you're not kissing me on the first date, eh? Praise the Lord. So you can set guidelines, eh? Standards. Seven are young on a matani date. Eh? Praise the Lord. You there, I here. You sit there, I sit on this side. Don't sit next to me. Sit over there. Kaya kaya kuchig wan dona restaurant. Kaya kaya kuchig wan dona bean cut wango. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Eh? Yeah. Praise the Lord. Kung ano taka mo na kaw taka mo yao. Don't do what I did, eh? When I was in school and I was trying to, you know. Hey baby, you wanna go, you know, just go to the shop there. And that time, you won't believe this, Ruben, that time the ice block was only 2 cents. So I said, you know, we go there to the shop, you know, one ice block for you, one ice block for me. I only got 5 cents. Praise the Lord. Yeah, she didn't even buy that one. Then, yeah, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah. That's what we came to when I thought a bean cut. I don't know, but you said, no! Sister Phyllis, God says, I'm not that cheap, no! Yeah, I was telling Auntie Oli, because we came to the bus stand, and we saw that people are eating in the bus stand, you know, the one they're just eating standing up? I said, Auntie Oli, maybe, you know, I take you there, you know? Auntie Oli says, you go there yourself. Praise the Lord. Amen, eh? Ah. Hallelujah, eh? So, it's our prayer, eh? Hey, praise the Lord. Be careful, eh? Be careful. Praise the Lord. It takes time to repair a broken heart. Amen. The prerequisites of dating. The next page, eh? From last night. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And the prerequisites of dating. Here it is. Prerequisites, it's just a fancy word for requirement. Yeah, so you can put it there. The requirements for dating. Yeah, or like Pastor Harry said, the condition for dating. Remember the condition we touched on in the mission training? Right. Well, the condition for dating. Yeah, so the requirement for dating. Yeah. You shouldn't be dating in the first place if you don't what?
Realize that marriage is the
pinnacle
of dating.
Okay. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Don't date now, because especially saying you're saying you're still schooling. Simbar mandani rawat yung doon na certificate.
Σεμπέρνει ράωνα δάκα-δάκα. Το σάμα είπα σαγά-σαρά τσίγκο να κάνω τον εγκαιμπίου σαρά εμμούρδι. Άρα λέω είναι σαρά του να δάκα-δάκα. Ε, γαία, πάρα μπορεί μπορεί τώρα το ρίκα, αλλά μπέριτς. Why you wanna be dating now? You thinking about marriage?
No.
Io, then why not it? Qua non è un goe. Sembra il ramo una bulli. Sembra il passi da exam. Se sembra in due una lagadaca, tu sa mai dei date sarci. Praise the Lord. Me mi vuoi chiedere la cruz? Alleluia. Praise the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Ok, realizing. Two, three.
Realizing the marriage is the ultimate goal should be the number one qualification for dating. Next would be to understand all God's requirements for marriage.
Amen. Yeah? Now we're going to go and touch marriage so you will know what is required in marriage. But now we're touching what is required for dating. Amen. Do I get out? Any question? Praise the Lord. I was gonna ask this mom and dad to share their experiences in dating, eh? But I was happy to talk about it, eh? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Don't get me talking about Marua. Praise the Lord, eh? Amen. Gailo Remanda. Brother Demesi, question.
Pastor, can you tell me what you're doing? You're doing more than what
you're
doing. You're doing more than what you're doing. You're
You know, when I was preparing, when God gave me the message about this, I looked at myself and I go, man, I wish somebody in the church was preaching this kind of message so I can make adjustment to my life while I was dating my wife. Eventually, my wife. Praise the Lord, eh? We could have done something. We could have made adjustments to it. But, yes, the ice block and all that was cheap. But not only that, we didn't have any kind of teaching like this in the churches this day. I come from the Methodist church, eh? The Methodist church wasn't preaching anything like this in the Methodist church that I was a member of. They weren't preaching any message like this. Praise the Lord. Actually, if I remember correctly, the youth, or they call it the MYF, it was actually like a social club where boys were meeting girls and girls were meeting boys. So I'm going to teach the youth the sala merau kira la bagawati. Praise the Lord. I don't know what the youth you came from. But, you know, that was like that. Amen. Does that answer your question, Brother Davis? Yes, ice block was very cheap then, that time. Eh? And plus, it was big ice block. Not this little cheap one. That was big ice block. Praise the Lord. Yeah, you start eating it from New World. You arrive here, you will just take the bite, eh? The last bit of it. Over there, the one you buy today. Are you just come past New World or the Seventh-day Adventist Church over there. All the ice block finish it. Yeah. Ice block in them days was very good. Praise the Lord. But that was back then, eh? Say, kali lim kin an ice block. Hallelujah. Dotale, dobe taro, dobe wase doraka. Any questions?
Back to dating,
Pastor. Back to dating. Yes. Yeah, to
dating. Never date any someone that you won't consider for marriage.
That's right.
If your prayer list, the one whom you are dating has got all that.
Yeah.
And
you're dating that person.
Yes.
Well, that's the ultimate goal, isn't it? Marriage. That you're gonna marry that person.
But later on.
Yeah. It falls apart on you, eh?
Yes.
Okay. If it falls apart on you, then you better pray some more, eh? You better pray some more. Praise the Lord. You better develop yourself some more. Remember, one of the answers to prayer is what? Wait. Mm-hmm. And also, another answer to prayer is no. Mm-hmm. We don't like the no part, eh? The wait part, well, we can handle that, eh? Anna, praise the Lord, eh? But the waiting part, eh?
You remember when God said to a promise to Abraham that he's going to have an Isaac? Do you know how long he had to wait?
Yes.
How long? How long did he wait?
Yes.
Try 25 years.
Yes.
Yeah. Rosaka burka lima na yampaki na nawara katiko pa na lubena magaisun. Eh? How many of you people are willing to wait for 25 years before your husband or your wife come? Oh, pastor, kung sa son lulu talaga ng ka. Now I'm gonna put thick makeup and thick lipstick. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah, not many people like the waiting part, eh? Amen. Praise the Lord, eh? Yeah, that's true, eh? Sometimes that happens in the dating thing, in the dating stage, eh? Sometimes that happens in the dating stage. Eh? Praise the Lord, eh? You think, ooh, it's nga, go kabinagan mo, kaset, on, salga. Eh? And then, yeah, on nga biko, but not on to God, eh? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Eh, God looks to more God. This girl needs more development, eh? Develop your prayer life. Develop your faith life. Yeah. Eh? Develop your worship life. And develop your cooking and sasamakibale life. Ha. No boy want to come home and just, honey, where's the food? Only the person I've been Facebooking all day. Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. You don't want the brother come home and cook again. Eh? You just sit in the front of the computer and Facebook and chat. And chat nga yan, yung ay tuberkuro mo na kinisong. Praise the Lord, that's the chat. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. But generally speaking, 2, 3.
But generally speaking, you're ready to
when you've met these 4 prerequisites, now we're going to deal with it, eh? Number 1, 2, 3.
You're aware of both the benefits and dangers of dating. In other words, you consider its advantages and disadvantages before you enter a dating relationship.
Amen? In other words, you have prepared yourself that your heart can be broken in the dating stage. Yeah? You've considered that, eh? Yeah, you have prepared yourself if you get dumped in the dating stage. Mereka kuni gaya bapak rumbu itu gaya bapak ni kawan. Oh man, aku gaya rendah kau serangai tahun ini rumah own hand serangai in front of my face. Yeah, praise the Lord. Yeah. So you better be prepared for that kind of thing because it can happen, it will happen. Praise the Lord. Kau kuni aku rumbu ikin lah, enak ya boy. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Iya, apa yang mencium ay?
Kesaya tu kaya pasto sambil serena.
Ah?
Kesaya tu kaya bangun sare tu bangun sambil serena. Kebanyakan 4 years of dating.
Yeah.
If you see that in your face or eyes,
uh-huh.
You have to leave him straight away or her.
Yeah, what happens if the brother comes? Sir, she's tired out, but we don't really want to. Ah, she's tired out. She's tired out. And you know, you and me, you know, we're an item. Kindle, us. Get that one up. If the boy wants to reconcile, what would you say?
Talk to the hand.
Talk to the hand, okay. Praise the Lord. If you've been betrayed in your relationship, be very careful.
Amen.
If he's playing you, then he can play you in the marriage.
Yes.
What you gonna buy by the baby? I'm going to buy Danny's and Danny's. But you shouldn't be dating somebody quite about you got in the first place anyway. You should be dating a Christian.
Amen.
Yeah, praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. Amen. Eh? Praise the Lord. Should never want to lay out a bit of tea. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Yeah? Hallelujah. Okay, Pastor Joe.
So,
I'm going to be
a Christian.
Yeah.
The Christians are not.
Ya, terima Kristen dalam cina pula. That should be the alarm bell should be ring, eh? Because yeah, it's only Christian by label, not Christian by practice. Praise the Lord, eh? Because that's only Christian by label, eh? It's not Christian by practice. Because you want a Bible believing, Bible practicing husband or boyfriend, well, girlfriend, eh? Begitu orang sebenarnya cuma dibawa. Praise the Lord, itu saya masuk dalam tipu anak nonong kok. Hallelujah.
Then she stuffed it down and goes, no, Pastor, you just say stay like that. Like, man, kim tuh sasa ngasaran lalu long. Kamu masuk apa, man, kalau pakai jenom tau Pastor dia. Meru nisa kota juga nunggu isu, ya, dia tuh nunggu isu. Praise the Lord, ya, haleluya. Did you want to ask me a question about the TMS? He lifted his hand up a little while ago.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What Ollie was saying?
Yeah.
When you found out that she or he is not the one.
Yeah.
She was cheating on you.
Yeah.
But then, it was God's purpose for him to marry you.
Yeah.
Then what? Sometimes when things happen.
Yeah.
That forgiveness comes in your heart.
Right.
And then you rejected him.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
What if God has chosen him or her for you?
Okay. Praise the Lord. That's a very good question, eh? Now, you remember in the Bible, there's a prophet called Hosea. Remember Hosea? Mm. Eh? God commanded Hosea to marry what type of girl?
Prostitute.
A prostitute. Praise the Lord. Eh? Now, you know, knowing the scriptures that we know now, eh? Do not be unequally yoked with unbelievers. Mm. So, let's just take me for example, eh? Because I'm not married. Hana? Ha. Okay, so if, let's say if God tells me, go marry somebody standing on the old car road. What would the reaction of the church? What would you say?
No.
No. Yeah, the church would say, are you sure you're hearing from God? Eh? Now, what's up with that? I'm going to look at you, eh? You sure you're a prophet? If you were a true prophet of God, eh, God wouldn't say something like that to a man of God, eh, to go marry a prostitute. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Eh? But you notice, God has a higher purpose. Eh?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Amen. God has a higher purpose in the reason why he's telling Hosea to go marry a prostitute, because that is exactly what the children of Israel were doing to God. God is their husband, and now that they have prostituted themselves by going and worshiping idols. Eh? There was a higher purpose in that, eh? So if that's also a possibility. There is also a possibility. Just to see your forgiveness heart. What's your forgiveness heart like? Are you able to forgive your boyfriend although he betrayed you and then take him back? The same thing with a husband, eh? If your husband went danis, yeah? Lah, my father, saya warik kuatin tu nak 4x2, skyline tiga, boom! Eh? Tamu lah kamu antara 4x2, cang. Okay, kau cik kuat talon na took him again to the hospital, eh? Then after the materi finish, then daddy says, oh look honey, I was sorry. You know, my workmates, they tell me to go. I said, no, they dragged me and then they had a couple of drinks and then, praise the Lord. So it can be also like that, eh? So you, grandpa, eh? So you need to be hearing from God. Develop relationship with the Lord. Develop your relationship from God so that when things like that happen, you can hear from God and you can see the purpose of God, eh? Yeah. In it all. Praise the Lord. Don't just get sold out, eh? To the first guy who comes along and says, hey baby, hello baby. You know, my heart goes, when I see you. You know, and when you wear that shoes, amen.
Amen.
Eh? Nga karuna. Masutiko sista. Masutiko, eh? Kaku nyo baka wele wele. Praise the Lord. Number two. 2, 3.
You woke up a set of personal dating standards from scripture, which simply means that in addition to God's standards, you establish your own personal values for choosing the right life partner.
Amen, eh? So you've got your own standards, eh? Huh? You've got your own standard, yeah? We won't go to any movie theater all by ourselves. Praise the Lord. Yeah? We won't go to Village 6, eh? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah? Because when the lights go down, they say in Australia, eh? When the cat is away, the mice will play. Ningwane mboko kina na wanga ni Village 6, Then brother put his hand around you and move your face like this and just saying, you know? Put our hand, draw you close, and then,
Amen.
Yeah, don't worry, I meant to go married. Praise the Lord, say something, eh?
Amen.
When don't gang around me, not a kingdom. Let's go village 6. Any village 6 here near Makoi here somewhere?
No.
So when you want to go village 6, where you go?
Oh.
Where you go to village 6?
Suva.
Oh, okay. Yeah. If I see one of you people in village 6 in Suva, praise the Lord, I'll say, tell Auntie Oli, buy one umbrella, let's go beat this person up.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah? What are you doing here watching a movie with your boyfriend here all by yourself? Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. So be careful, eh? Don't go to places like that, eh? Hallelujah. Where the mice can play. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Eh?
Because all the mice and the money wushi and all the kalabo and all that will play, eh? Hallelujah. So don't put yourself in an uncompromising position where you will compromise on your Christian values and stand it. Those are rather been like a ticker. Yeah? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah? Hallelujah. Because myself, I don't want to marry any of you girls. Yeah? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We've already talked about that last night. Eh? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Number three. Two, three.
You close in your heart to lower your sins. Even if it means losing dates or relationships.
Amen. That's a very important one. Are you prepared for that? Because don't compromise on your Christian values, eh? And standards. Now standard or something, that's it. Yeah, these are my conditions. Baby, if you want to go out with me, this is it here. If you don't like it, tosos artigo. Amen. I'm not that kind of girl. Amen. Amen. You better stick to your Christian standards and values for dating, eh? Don't lower your standards for anybody. Make time, yeah. Oh, I don't go to my Bible college. Who cares? Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. Sure. That's what they all say. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Eh? Don't lower your dating standards for anybody, no matter who they are. Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay, let's continue. 2, 3.
This is especially important because emotions can pull you in the wrong direction. If you're not careful, you are meant to decide for you what you do in the experience of a dating relationship. But most of the time, you will not receive what you are dealing with until you've been dating for at least 6 months. By then, the initial feelings are going to level off.
That's good advice, eh? That's very good advice. Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. So you set it from right from the start. Eh? Make it like your brother. To know I'm going to condition, eh? This is the condition. Praise the Lord. If you're not willing to meet these conditions, plenty of fishes in the sea, brother. You're not the only good-looking guy around here. Amen. God has got something better for me than just you. If you think you're the best thing since sliced bread, to know what? Plenty of sliced bread going around. Hallelujah. Amen. Yeah. Let me take a sliced bread. Huh? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yeah. Eh? Don't lower your standards for anybody. Eh? And don't allow anybody. Come on, this one no good. No, don't do that. Eh? So Catholic no equal. You go not Catholic. So I don't want to call you. My standard is not going to call you. Well, I'm not going to take anything out of this standard. You now, if you can't meet the conditions, out. Go somewhere else. Eh? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. And any question before we move on to number four?
Dometaro, Dolikem Donomonelo, Cinematata Tico Bois. Any of you young girls, eh? Cinematata Tico, it's not clear. You want me to elaborate or expand on it? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Samatata Tico, say, Dometaro, Donaka. Any question? Sarah, praise the Lord. Are you Pastor Joe? Yes. This, listen, there's nothing wrong with that, eh? But you better make sure that you're praying, eh? Before you approach the guy. Praise the Lord. Because any guy you approach, because we've learned about the standards of dating, eh? You better make sure about those standards, eh? That's very clear in your heart. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, eh? You better be very clear in your heart, eh? Praise the Lord. Kwaengo, eh? Monganga runi binaka, eh? Masu, eh? Meruni. Yeah, because, they say in Australia that opposites attract. Yes, that's true. Opposites attract. Hallelujah. Kwa sarang na tanga na kito siya sarang di mga boto mo data ang yung data kasi we but that's okay. Yeah, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Auntie Ollie, you want to say something?
If God gives that boy or that girl to him or to her,
yeah,
it's not our opinion, it's God's.
Yes.
Amen to that.
Yes, amen to that. Yeah, parents, listen up. Become the time, Tina. Eh, moms and dads, please listen up. God only knows. Sometimes parents want to interfere in the relationship of their children. Eh? Be very careful. Because sometimes when you do that, what the children do, they elope. Because, we don't like the boy that she brought home. So, she's not marrying the whole family. She says, marry the boy. And praise the Lord. And he's not marrying the whole family. He's only marrying the girl. Because they can go and have their own family and do their own thing, eh? But for the relatives of that boy, of that girl, man, we don't like him. Look at him. We don't like him. They don't even know the guy. Praise the Lord. Sometimes they know the guy, eh? But, that's your daughter or that's your son's choosing, eh? If that's what they choose, all you can do is give the advice, eh? Hey, you know about this guy? You know about his background? Eh? You know about what kind of family he comes from? You can only give the advice. After that, leave it to them. Eh? If anything goes wrong with their relationship, it's their fault. You make the bed, you sleep on it. Eh? Praise the Lord. Sabi ako mga kaya pala Joe. Eh? Yeah. Kaya ito nang gangaraw ni kina na tama pati kina tina. Be careful. Eh? Don't interfere. Don't interfere in your children's relationship. Eh? Let them believe God and develop their faith concerning their relationship. Eh? Praise the Lord. But sati ko nga na nora in naki muni na kalo ben palata na nora mula na lubi abwe. And they all could be different. Each person, eh? Yo te lakas na kero ka pa na lubi abwe. I've got four kids, eh? If pa na lubi abwe, if all of them could have, that God could have four different plans for the four kids. Praise the Lord. So you let them learn and experience God for themselves, eh? Develop themselves. Yeah, you can give them advice to help them along, grow in God, in their relationship with God, eh? But please don't interfere with their relationship, eh? Sometimes that causes trouble, eh? Yeah, on both sides. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. That's good, good. Dotale, any more questions? Yeah.
Kasih bulu tulen biru.
Ya.
Kucing nak sali dan muka misali kor.
Right.
Saya ni tulen tu kor mungkin orang impor pun ada nak beli sisi.
Ya.
Saya bila kata kor mewah kor.
Ya.
Tahu nak kata kor.
Okay. What you can do is that around your what I say advice take kor.
Advice.
Advice. Eh? And pray. And pray. Much prayer. Yeah. But let them go. This is the reason why I said prayer and much prayer and also advice is that because of this I fell in love. I fell in love. Man, you're only 16. Huh? How would you know about love? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you're only 16.
You don't know anything about love.
Yep.
Praise the Lord. Eh?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Yeah. So, and then they get married, and then they find out, woo! It's not what I think it is. Yeah, because now you've got your in-laws, you've got the baby now. Yeah? Who's going to buy the nappy? Who do you think is going to babysit? That's why I said it. Yeah. Woolly mother. Go to school, get an education, get a job, so that you can buy the nappy for your own children. Eh? Not only that, so you can pay your own wedding. Don't expect mom and dad to pay for your own wedding. Eh?
Yeah.
Yeah. You work, save up, and pay for your own wedding. Yeah, the 21st birthday these days is costing maybe about $5,000, $10,000 to run a 21st birthday. So wedding, with all the people coming, yeah, you're looking at about what, maybe $15,000 plus. Yeah. So save up until you got $15,000, then get married, eh? Because yeah, we're not gonna just give up $15,000 for you to go and get married, and then after that, 2 years later, you break up, eh? Yeah. And then when you have another wedding, don't expect to ask for us to come and pay another $15,000, eh? Ah. Praise the Lord. You've got to figure that out and take that into consideration when you want to get married. Because somebody's going to be paying for something, eh? For your wedding. Praise the Lord. Amen. Choir, eh? That's good. That's a good question, eh? Amen, eh? That's a good question. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Who just got recently married here? How much did your wedding cost, Vikash? Roughly?
More than 10.
So there you go. Mm-hmm. They got married last year. So 10. So we came to the money let you go. So I hope you've got $10,000 in the bank to pay for your wedding. Eh? Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. Yeah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Eh? Okay. Amen. Jotala Betaro, any question? Jotala Taro? Any more question? Anybody want to say something? Praise the Lord, Sarah. All right. Praise the Lord. Number four, please. 2, 3.
Never, never did such a woman consider for marriage. The main reason for establishing herself as a before you start the date is to see God apart from the
marriage. That is so true, eh? That is so true. Praise the Lord. Marangkini no baka sangra na kalo. Seek God. Eh? Because this is what happened. See, when you have a boyfriend or a girlfriend, you know, boyfriend wants to spend time with you. You want to spend time with boyfriend. You text, eh? Chat, eh? Facebooking and all that. And you take the picture and you put it on Facebook so we can see, eh? Who's your current boyfriend? Praise the Lord. Amen. Huh? Yeah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Yeah. Yeah. Eh? So now we know. Ooh, this is the guy this one is going out with, eh? Praise the Lord. Eh? Yeah. Yeah. So don't be a color boy. Praise the, don't be the red. This is the reason why we're touching this. Praise the Lord. And the sang about the move of praise the Lord.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Be careful of what you put on social media, because all of us are watching and looking. The whole world is seeing what you're putting up.
Yeah.
I said that last night. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Okay, you need 2, 3. Amen. That's true. Eh? That is true. Eh? So when brother wants to take you to where the mosquitoes are biting, you know exactly what to say. Amen. Eh? Praise the Lord. So when brother invites you to go to a party that you know there's going to be alcohol and drugs in there, you know exactly what to say.
Amen.
Amen. Taleani. When brother says, let's go do the Charlie Charlie game, what are you going to say?
No.
I rebuke you in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. Let's continue. 2, 3.
That's why it's important to lay the groundwork for evaluating relationships first. You will avoid a lot of problems if you don't consider getting close to someone unless
next person meets your criteria.
Amen. So I hope you've got your criteria all done, eh? To Sataraman and Mother South. Make a list. How many have made a list? Demis is only Demis made a list and Ruben made a list. Oh, thank you, Ruben. look at Cindy girls. What?
She has given.
Praise the Lord, eh? Hallelujah. So make a list, eh? Praise the Lord. Yeah. The list is Hallelujah. Atiol is laughing, eh? I said I made a list a long time ago. I don't know, maybe it's torn up now somewhere, eh? Praise the Lord, eh? Maybe I'll put it in a bottle or some like message in a bottle type of thing. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Some basic dating standards or guidelines, eh? Here we go. 2, 3.
One of the reasons why so many marriages suffer from breakups and problems is that the couple never laid the proper groundwork. Something they should have done before they started dating. Many of the complications for choosing the right life partner would be the dating standards that they should set. You can evaluate each standard ahead of time by asking yourself, how will such and such person affect the relationship? Will it help build or destroy the marriage?
Amen. Well, boy, this is only advice, so you don't have to include this in your list. But you can if you want to. When you're believing or praying for your lifetime partner, you know, I said last night, put spiritual values first. Yeah? So you can pray. Let's say if a young girl is praying, this is what you can say to the Lord. You say, Lord, I'm believing for a lifetime partner that His weakness will be made up by my strengths, and my weaknesses will be made up by His strength. Praise the Lord. Kwae go eh? Na no na malumalumo sister, eh na my bukea, na buno eko koko kino brother. Eh na buno e malumalumo kino brother, eh na my bukea, eh na buno eko koko kino sister. So both of you are strong, eh? One. Praise the Lord. When one of your moms and dads listen, eh? Became the Tina Kenatama. Moms and dads, this is what you should be praying for your children. Kuni bahalay ba tigo merto na lumiyam mo to merto ng ay eh masulat ng anong to lifetime partner. You as a parent, eh? You when the don mendua tigo na tiki tunde ni no masulat ka eh no tina to na lumiyam. You should be praying for the husbands and for the wives if you got boys. Go to God. Exercise your faith. Start believing for it. Amen?
Amen.
Because you want your children to marry good people, not bad people. Eh?
Amen.
Criminal. So you better start praying then. Eh? The daughter is praying and the mommy and daddy is praying. Watin naman tayo matikita, kung doon doon sarang meron, dami ba doon, kung masula ka na watin, right? Nalubay mong raw. Praise the Lord. Nino na unya-unya may kinanonan raw family, they'll come to you, eh? You don't want that in your old age. Children coming back to mommy and daddy, eh? Because their family, their marriage, eh? The marriage has got problems in it. Amen. Just a thought. I thought I might just mention it. So start praying, eh? For your children's lifetime partner. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Okay, here are Psalm 2, 3.
Here are some basic standards that everyone should consider. Keep in mind that the list will be longer depending on the individual person's standards and the standards God has set for them.
Number one.
It is a person and committed Christian.
Amen. Is a person a committed Christian? Is he or she serving God and serving God well? Eh? Not only when it comes to Christmas and New Year, then we see them at the what's the party in Sumo they have to have in heaven? The what?
Party.
Yeah, the street party, the Mardi Gras they have in Suva. Eh? And then after that, they come January, February, then we see them come back to church. So you better make sure. Number two.
Is this person compatible with my life goals?
Okay. Is this person compatible with my life goals?
Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. Eh? Is a person an early riser? Is he lazy? Does he like exercise? Praise the Lord. Eh? Will he? Eh? Does he like to study and learn and increase? Oh? Say, I just want to stay home and just grass cut over and maybe not even weed the cassava. And you have to plant the cassava. Praise the Lord, sister.
Amen.
Number 3.
Does the person have any self-control?
Wow. Does the person have any self-control? Eh? Or just one small finger? Hey, hey, what do you say? What do you think I am? What do you think I am? Huh? What do you think? And hang you by the arm. What do you think? Bang, 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 bang. Huh? Don't talk to me like that. Who you think are you talking to now? Eh? I'm gonna get the truth and borrow you and your father and your mother. Eh? A hot-tempered person. That's what I'm trying to say. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. How many girls you want to be slept around in your relationship? Lamilinga. Eh? How many girls want to be slept around by their husband or boyfriends? Oh, nobody. Okay. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Number 4, 2, 3. So you better check out, eh? What kind of family he or she comes from. Eh? Are they a loving family or do they argue all the time? Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Otondo Bilomani, my nona matabubale. Or his father just matani every weekend. You go to the house, no glass cups or saucers over there. Because the father smash everything.
Man.
Kaka borra. And the lubas, no lubas there. Because the father smash, boom, one punch. Where's the food? When he's drunk. What kind of family the boy comes from or the girl comes from? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yeah. Number 5. This is the question that Brother Joe was asking. Say, buli buli sartunga. Sabi abang mau, sabi abang wati. School, school, school. I want to get married straight away. Is the timing right to pursue this relationship? Praise the Lord. Mga bimbi, kaya mga kaisin na katakot yung brother. Brother doesn't have a job. Both of you, no job. And you want to get married. Who do you think is going to pay for the wedding? Kung nga ni pagtaka kwa edaka pa ng dona turanga ya. They went, they didn't tell anybody. Neither of their family know that they were getting married that day. They just go to the, what's the marriage thing here? In Suba. What the house is there? Suba house. They went there. They went there, got the marriage there. And then they come home. They said, oh, we got married. What? We got married. Oh, we better make something for your lunch, eh? They sit down. One person go to the cupboard, open the cupboard. Bring one deep fish, put it down there. Here, that's for your lunch. Praise the Lord. Eh? O de abi na kata me kena kakena ngani baka mau indo ngani na kava samani. Who want TV just for their wedding lunch? Any girl here want that kind of thing? No, you don't even want the bean cup taking, eh? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah. Eh? Well, you want a tin fish. You talk about cheap wedding. Eh? Because that one there, or maybe only $1.20, eh? Wedding that one. Huh? Far out. Eh? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah. Kung ano yung dapat na matagalik kami, baka mawaya. Praise the Lord. Doon na kawasaman. Hallelujah. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah. You never know. That just gave me an idea. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Well, which part are we up to?
You are 6.
Number 6. 2, 3.
What is the person called to do? Is that he compatible with mine?
Praise the Lord. Hey, Manny. Is he a musician? Yeah, is he a prophet? Is he an apostle? Is he a pastor? What kind of gift? Matangali suri suri baka namin yano tamu tsukobwa. Praise the Lord.
Yeah,
what kind of... Yeah, what kind of a spiritual gift does the person carry? Is he a worship leader? Yeah? Is he a dance leader? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Don't mash it on the lawa.
Yeah, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Number 7, 2, 3. This is very careful with this one here, because sometimes people want to get married because they have a need on the inside. Eh? They think that getting married will fulfill that need. No man in the world will fulfill that need, only Jesus.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
Eh? No man in the world, or no woman in the world, if you're a man, praise the Lord. Eh? And the second one, praise the Lord. Eh? Praise the Lord. 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 Hallelujah. Amen. Eh? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So, eh? Whatever issue you've got in your heart, get that sorted out before you get involved in a marriage situation. Because otherwise, you will be taking your excess luggage into the marriage.
Yes.
And now you want the husband to fix it, and the husband hasn't got any ability whatsoever to fix your excess luggage. Get yourself sorted out.
Amen.
Remember what I said last night? If you are discussing about the port, let the discussion stay with the what?
Pot.
Don't bring the
play the knife,
the kurniti and all that. Don't bring it in. Eh, kaya wakatubi mo sa kita ka ng DC. Oh, na rubi, si tala nga ba ng bukit. Kaya wakatubi mo sa kita ka ng DC, na rubi pa, rubi pa, tala ng DC. Medyo ko nga ba ng DC. Kung lang ito makinan na corona. Eh, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Ba't tiyan nga ng DC ng bukit? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Eh? So if you're arguing, well, let's just put a religious label on it. Intense fellowship. If you're having an intense fellowship with your wife or husband, and you're talking about the plate, don't bring the pot, teapot, and all the other utensils into it. Huh? Praise the Lord, Hallelujah. That's just good advice for you girls and boys when you get into a relationship. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. 2, 3. You are sent.
You have set standards that are important to you and
stay with them. That way, when you find someone comfortable with you, you will know you have to
spend the right life partner. Now, this is not the time to jump into marriage. This is the time that you
may know that you need to spend some time with this person to know what they are like. Amen. So, when you find your right life partner, men are going to the warfare. Praise the Lord. When you find your right, what is it supposed to be?
Lifetime
partner. That's what I meant to say. Praise the Lord. Words are not coming out. That's not the time to marry that person. That's the time to start praying together and develop it. What it's going to be like when you get married. Tell them, oh, I found him. I found him now. I found him. No, don't go marry him. Yeah, praise the Lord. Yeah. Because let me say this to you. Because no person is perfect, eh?
Yes.
Yeah.
And therefore, listen up, no relationship or no marriage will be perfect.
Mm.
Praise the Lord. Mm. If brother is perfect, why would he more want to marry you? You're not perfect. And if you are perfect, why would you want to marry somebody else? You're perfect. You don't need a partner. Just a thought. Eh? Just a thought. If you are perfect, why would you want to get married? Amen. All right, any questions? Do I have a taro? Yo, na taro may lang may tayo. Huwag doon kung dumitaro yung tsaka makikin doon kung doon giggle tsaka, giggle tsaka. Huwag doon taro may taki. Taro, debe taro, debe kain doon ka. Any question? Any of the married people who would like to contribute into this discussion, because you have been very quiet. Any of the married couple want to share something of their personal or experiences as they go through this dating stage and finally getting married? Would you like to share it with us? Would you like? Yeah, Brother Joe. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Praise the Lord.
I wish I had this stuff with me when I would have saved myself sleeping alone in the lounge room in the winter. I got kicked out of the bedroom, blue bedroom. Get out of here. Go sleep in the bedroom. What about the blanket? No blanket. Go find your own blanket. What's up? Amen. Man, this is rough. What about the washing the clothes? No, wash your own clothes. What about the food? Oh, forget the food. You think I'm only here to cook and wash for you? What do you think you are? Sir, sister, but I love you. Oh, what kind of love is this? Now we're laughing at it now, eh? When it's happening right there and then, both kachi kachi and mitsa, eh? Oh, man, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Yeah, Gina, that's true, eh? But we weren't being taught these principles, eh? We weren't being taught. Kemningo, man, you're so blessed.
Yes.
You're so blessed.
Yes.
You're so blessed. Because you know all this, eh? Kemamingo, saying, hey, man, what are you fighting? You know, I married a Samoan lady. Praise the Lord. You talk about the churi yawe. Are, man, I got the umbrella thrown at me. Praise the Lord. Yeah, the wife got angry with me one day. Hey, what are you doing? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. All the good times and the bad times in the marriage, eh? Hallelujah. Now we're laughing at it, eh? Man, Reuben, when that was happening, oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, eh? Hallelujah. Anybody want to share something? Auntie Holly, would you like to share something about what we've been touching, your experience? Any of the Gomera?
I believe some of these points which you have got, one to seven.
Yeah.
Can be defeated
because
of no marriage is perfect.
Okay.
Looking at it, all these points.
Yeah.
So to sum up with that,
yeah.
Some of them can be defeated because no marriage is perfect.
Yes.
No relationship is perfect.
That's right. Amen. That's right. That's where the preparation stage in. We need to develop ourselves, eh? Because every Christian marriage or Christian relationship will be tested, eh? It will have an opposition by the devil. Amen. Mm-hmm. The devil will come against it to try to break it up. Praise the Lord. So be prepared. Eh? Your prayer life should be on. I went home here last night. I kept on hearing the word aunts. I woke up this morning. Aunts. Don't know what aunts is. I think that aunt is good. Eh? Is that good? Aunts is supposed to be good? Okay, aunts. Aunts. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. That's good. I'm telling you. That's true. Praise the Lord. Ndotale, anybody want to contribute? Hallelujah. Demesi, did you want to say something? Would you like to say something about that? Because in this youth, we are not going to know. Would you like to share something?
I am blessed.
Praise the Lord.
Because of most of my friends and all of my colleagues that I grew up with, they all got married.
Praise the Lord.
But most of them now are coming back to me and asking me for advice. Some of them are calling me for a marriage like this. Eh? I always told them, I have never gone through that situation. But only thing I can advise you is that you have to go to Jesus. You have to pray. Yeah?
Amen.
Because I haven't learned so much about marriage. But now I've seen so much that you have taught us today.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
It gives me an idea.
Praise the Lord. Man,
actually, and you should seek God first.
Amen.
And in everything.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Demis. Eh? God is true. Eh? The word of God is right. Eh? Praise God. Seek first the kingdom of God and His
righteousness
and all these things, including the wife, including the husband. Eh? God will give it. Parmeshwar will give it to us. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Any of the young married couple want to say something? Vikash and your wife, would you like to say something about the stuff that the dating and the marriage that we've been, just been sharing? Is it doing anything for you? Are you learning anything? Can you share from your experience that you were from the stuff that we've been saying something?
In fact, this is first time for us to hear this thing.
Praise the Lord.
That we learned during this session. And while we went through this, then I came to know that what we lacked in it, what we took for it,
right,
and what we missed.
Right.
So now we are trying to put ourselves on this step that we have been taught.
Okay. Nah. Thank you. Eh? That's good, eh? Clap for offering to Jesus, eh? Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Nothing is too late for God, eh? God, yeah, we can just for some of us who have gone through the marriage stage, we can, you know, sit down together as husband and wife, apologize to each other, say sorry to each other, and then pray together for God to heal the damage. Yeah, that was done in our dating stage or marriage or something that's been done within the marriage. Amen. Praise the Lord. Nothing's too late. Thank you. Praise the Lord. Brother Ruben, would you like to share something about what we've been discussing tonight?
One of the things Pastor said that you'll find they'll have values that complement each other.
Yes.
So that's very important, especially for the young ones to know. We came to know this, we're learning it now.
Yeah.
But otherwise we were learning through experience these sort of things.
Yes.
And then in between, of course, through experience, you experience both sides of it.
Yes.
But your partner might not be exactly just as you are.
Yeah.
So, for us, if it came to anger management, I was the anger, she was the management.
Praise the Lord.
So, things like that whatever you are, the other person will not be exactly like that.
Yes.
But that other person is an extension of you.
Yeah.
That will complement your own values.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
That's very good advice. Praise the Lord. Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah. It'll be boring if you marry the same person like you were. Very boring. Yeah. You know, thinks like you, talks like you, walks like you, and does everything just like you. Be very boring marriage. Praise the Lord. Yeah, be very boring.
Why?
Well, the reason is, I'll say here, because you are strong in the same side and you're weak in the same side. So both of you will be weak in that area. Nobody to compliment each other. And nobody's complimenting each other. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Okay, mama, when I go, because I have a weak point here, you'll have to get it from somewhere. Praise the Lord. And that's the area the devil will attack. Eh?
Yeah.
That's the area the devil will attack. You will find most of the argument and the fight and the running back home by the girl in that area, because the devil will exploit it.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Sabe so my auntie Oli. Praise the Lord. Dotale kain dora ka. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Sasep ya, eh? Can we continue the rest of it next week, eh? You know, Phil says, no. Tu nak kap kira ngang, oh. Tu nak kaya ucingai kaya ngang mani di. Praise the Lord. Amen. Yes, Amelia. Metarang dora ka? No. All right. Praise the Lord. Eh? Let's just stand up and pray. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Eh? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Nakabalev Chisu. It's been quite an experience, quite a journey. Eh? Learning these things. Amen.
Amen.
It's quite an experience. Eh? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Eh? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can you just say a word of thank you to Parmeshwar? Eh? Hallelujah for the stuff that we're learning through. From his word concerning relationship and dating and marriage.
torrent on our number, but what you not talking about? They kind of sublimated to my own vossa. Hallelujah, we kind of sublimated to the kina. Hallelujah, we kind of sublimated to now we live in a clue. Thank you, Jesus. Now we live, Jesus. Imami, Rokomi Kemuni, Imami. Hallelujah, but I will take Kemuni in a clue. Now we live. Hallelujah, now we live, Jesus. Hallelujah, Father God, we thank you for tonight. We thank you for each person that is represented here, each family, each marriage, Lord God, each household. We pray, Father God, that you'll equip us and, Father God, grow us into the image of the Lord Jesus Christ. Help every young person here who's going through the dating stage and also the relationship stage. And also will be entering into the marriage stage. So we pray that you will strengthen them. Lord God, give them the wisdom to make right choices and make wise decisions. Father God, I pray in the name of Jesus that they won't be led away or led astray by peer pressure. Father God, I pray, Lord God, equip them with the necessary tools, Father God, that will help them to make godly decisions and godly choices. Thank you, Father God. Bless each and every one of us here. Lord God, we pray for the covering of the blood of Jesus as we make our way home. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't forget church service on Sunday. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Be blessed. Praise the Lord.
Notes.
And don't forget to bring your notes next week. Praise the Lord. Amen. Yeah?